2 days ago, Russian President Vladimir Putin arrived in Mariupol by helicopter for a visit. During the period, he drove a car to inspect multiple locations in the area and talked with local residents. In an interview with the media, Putin said that Russia originally hoped that the Donbass issue could be resolved peacefully. However, military support from Western countries has delayed the war to this day. This is the first time that Russian President Vladimir Putin has visited eastern Ukraine since the outbreak of the Russia-Ukraine war. In addition to Mariupol, Putin also made a surprise visit to Sevastopol in Crimea and the Russian Army's Special Operations Headquarters. The places visited by Russian President Vladimir Putin during this trip are of great significance. Sevastopol can be said to be the most important city in the Crimea region. During World War II, this was the key target of the German attack. Until now, Sevastopol is still the base of the Russian Black Sea Fleet. The recent incident of a US drone being shot down by a Russian warplane happened in the southern waters of Crimea. Sevastopol, a strategic location, is the target of the US military's key reconnaissance. Mariupol is also very important. It is one of the largest port cities around the Sea of Azov and the second largest city in Donetsk. At the beginning of the outbreak of the Russo-Ukrainian war, the Russian army and the Ukrainian army fought for several months here, and it is currently controlled by Russia. At the end of September last year, Russia held a referendum, and Mariupol was declared to join the Russian Federation. Security is one of the main issues Putin faces during this trip. We must know that Mariupol is only 150 kilometers away from Bakhmut, where Russia and Ukraine fought fiercely. As early as February, the United States agreed to provide Ukraine with GLSDB precision-guided munitions with a range of 150 kilometers, which can be launched using the Ukrainian Army's existing HIMARS. This means that if the Ukrainian Army or NATO obtains detailed information about Putin's visit to Mariupol, the Ukrainian Army may use this weapon to attack it in a point-blank manner, with unimaginable consequences. The Russo-Ukrainian war is a war of political significance. Once something happens to Putin, the hardline leader of Russia, the war may end quickly. However, according to various media reports, the Russian president's visit to Mariupol was carried out late at night, with only a few entourages following him. Scheduling the visit late at night is likely to increase security. After all, Ukraine has launched many attacks against senior Russian officials before. It is worth noting that the day before Putin's visit, the International Criminal Court issued a warrant for his arrest for war crimes. But the agency does not have the power to enforce the verdict, so its symbolism is far greater than its practical significance. The Kremlin said Putin's trip was not pre-planned. Therefore, at present, Putin's surprise visit to eastern Ukraine is expressing contempt for the West. The battle for Mariupol had already ended in the first half of last year. At present, the land belongs to the rear area, and the issue of people's livelihood is more important. Although Russia has actually controlled Mariupol and legally incorporated it into Russia through the organization of a referendum, the international community generally does not recognize this, just like the Crimea voted for Russia. At present, if the Russian army fails to make significant progress in the decisive battle of the Russo-Ukrainian war, then Ukraine's determination to regain lost ground will inevitably prompt the Ukrainian army to return to Mariupol, or even Crimea. At present, the Bakhmut campaign has entered a critical stage. Earlier this month, Russian Defense Minister Shoigu visited Mariupol. In January, Russian President Vladimir Putin visited here again. From this point of view, this trip also has the purpose of cheering for the frontline Russian army. If victory is achieved in the Battle of Bakhmut, then Russia is likely to start peace talks with Ukraine on the basis of the actual control area. After all, Russia's strategic goals have been basically achieved. The losses caused by this war are also increasing, and it is very beneficial to Russia to end it now.